Nel settore software, ed in particolare tra gli strumenti per la correzione colore, al NAB abbiamo assistito a piccole e grandi rivoluzioni, ad iniziare dal nuovo software SpeedGrade, già della Iridas e recentemente acquisito da Adobe, e che rende di fatto la Production Premium finalmente completa, fin nella correzione colore. Per capire di cosa si tratta, abbiamo fatto una chiacchierata con Coley Smith, Senior Architect di Adobe System.
We're not talking about price yet. But it used to be $45,000. Seriously. Now it's going to be in the box with Production Premium. So whatever the price is, you're going to be happy. So the main feature of SpeedGrade is color grading and conforming and basically DI. So bringing in images, converting from offline to online, conform those, color grade them, work with masks and secondaries, unlimited secondaries and primaries, and then output to whatever format you want. We can also, for the first time now, go from Premiere Pro to SpeedGrade. So Premiere Pro CS6 has a feature where you can send it right from Premiere Pro to SpeedGrade. It takes your timeline and converts it to DPX files, 10-bit, beautiful quality, and then the timeline is converted from a Premiere Pro timeline into a SpeedGrade timeline ready for you to edit. Typical grading applications, most only work with DPX files. They force you to work in DPX. We do work with movie files, we do work with still image files, Arri Raw, Alexa, Phantom, Silicon Imaging, RED files. We debayer those all in, live inside here, and some QuickTime files. So not all of them across the board, but most people will be probably bringing in high-res DPX files, or if they've been lucky enough to shoot on Alexa or RED, then they'll be bringing in those files and editing them there. Since SpeedGrade NX to CS6, they've introduced a brand new layer-based metaphor, something that Adobe users are very comfortable with. You're used to it in After Effects and Photoshop. You've got a layer, you make a change, you turn a layer off, turn it on, and it just works. So there's no restriction to the amount of layers, the amount of things you do with a layer. You can add a layer and just do a tiny thing, or one layer can have lots of changes.